Another week, another liberal scandal. This week, Ethics Commissioner Mario Dion released a finding that David MacNaughton, the former ambassador extraordinary and plenipotentiary of Canada to the United States, and found that he had breached Section 33 of the Conflict of Interest Act. Dion also cited 9 senior liberals, including 2 senior cabinet ministers, and the chief of defense staff, who were told to have no further dealings with MacNaughton. MacNaughton served as ambassador from March 2016 to August 2019. He is a lifelong liberal and was appointed as ambassador by Prime Minister Justin Trudeau. MacNaughton, again a lifelong liberal, has served as senior advisor in the office of Don Jamieson, who served sequentially as Minister of Transport, Industry, and ultimately Foreign Affairs. When he left the federal government, he became principal secretary to Ontario Liberal leader and premier Dalton McGuinty. He is a liberal backroom boy. He was one of the architects of the 2015 Liberal election campaign that saddled this country with Trudeau as the prime minister. After he left office as ambassador, he began working with a private company bent on getting lucrative government contracts in the area of data mining and analysis. That's when he started lobbying Liberal officials and ministers, including the current Minister of Finance, Chrystia Freeland. But none of this should really surprise anyone. The Liberals have a long history of corruption and ethics violations. Just in recent history, it tracks back to then Prime Minister Jean Chrétien, who was embroiled in the Shawinigate scandal, which resulted in an RCMP investigation and meandered its way through the courts for nearly 15 years. Then there was the HRDC scandal, the billion-dollar boondoggle, Chuck Gitte funneling money to Quebec companies, Alfonso Galliano, a cabinet minister, and his mob connections. There were no shortage of scandals with the Liberal Party. In a February 2019 column for True North, after the firing of then Justice Minister Jody Wilson-Raybould by Trudeau for not doing his bidding in the SNC-Lavalin scandal, I wrote about the many Liberal scandals, many of which were subject of RCMP investigations. At one point in the early 2000s, there were 5 separate RCMP investigations into the Chrétien government scandals. That culminated with the AdScam scandal and ultimately in the Gomery inquiry and the prosecution and conviction of several Liberal Party insiders and ultimately the fall of the Paul Martin government. The Liberals don't seem to believe that the rules apply to them. Certainly not the Prime Minister, who has already fallen afoul of the Ethics Commissioner 3 times, and is currently under yet another ethics investigation in the WE scandal. As we speak, there may be 2 separate investigations by the RCMP into senior Liberal Party insiders, including the Prime Minister. Are Canadians becoming inured to all the corruption? I suspect so. In June, the Parliamentary Budget Office reported it was unable to find evidence relating to a whopping 20,000 infrastructure projects out of an announced program costing $187 billion. It's not just no information on projects, there is no accounting from Minister Catherine McKenna's office on at least $2 billion that remain totally unaccounted for. $2 billion! It was precious little coverage in the mainstream media. Independent media sources like Blacklocks broke this story. It was covered by outlets such as Rebel News and True North, but mostly ignored by the mainstream media, who are so busy carrying water for the Prime Minister. MacNaughton has been in or around Liberal governments most of his adult life. He knows the rules, and he clearly should have known that he couldn't lobby ministers for government contracts once he left a federally appointed position of an ambassador to work for a private company. Equally, the senior party members involved, including the ministers, should have been aware of the rules and guided themselves accordingly. But that's not the Liberal way. For True North, I'm Leo Knight.